Hi from Robotic Creations, and today we're looking at OttoDIY's website and the Academy. We have Otto Blocky to download, install and start some coding. We're going to resources to show you where you can learn to build, learn to code and learn to design. We're actually going to do software for coding. There's this YouTube video on Otto Blocky, which is Light Scratch, which is a drag and drop block code. It's a standalone software, so once you installed it on your laptop, you do not need internet. I have Windows, so I downloaded a Windows program where you want to load it, okay, which I have already installed. One thing you do have to remember is to download the USB drivers for Windows, Linux or Mac, whichever one you have. I installed the software first and then I installed the driver. And the driver is used to have your Otto recognize your USB device when Otto is connected, okay? Down here you have open guide that will show you about Blocky. I'll leave that to you to read that through to understand what is involved. And this is the toolbar which is at the top that shows you the functions. Now we are going to pop out of that and we're going to go into Otto. There we go. I have Arduino Nano, but the new firmware, so I've got to change mine to Nano. We have different levels. Here is level 1, level 2, so you get more in the menu. More stuff to play with, okay? I'll just leave them at 3. Now, the samples are here. So you can just click on one of these and it'll show you how to center the servos, which I used when building with the students to make sure everything was aligned. I noticed we got pin rotations. It should be changed to 2, 3, 4, and 5. That is in the software. So all these will line up your servers for the legs, left, right, and feet, left, right. Back to folder. I actually have made my own code, introduction first code, for my students who are about 10 years old. This is for my after school program I do, STEAM program. And I found it's the easiest way to introduce this code for them. I shall just introduce you to Otto. This one I have designed a bit myself. So it's on the same Otto in version 12 file. But I've actually made a Lego top. So you can actually put Lego on it. And it's a slider, so we can actually slide other things like hats on top. Now, Otto, I connect him at the back with this, which is a macro USB, into the connection of the Nano board. Then we actually pop him in. Okay, so it's USB standard. Beeps, so the connection works. If it doesn't double beep, you might have a problem, but you can find that out as you go along. It's actually connected to COM4, communications 4. There is already some code in there, so it's already starting. If you have problems with it, you can always turn Otto upside down while he's doing that, okay? Right. Now, we're going to go into this a little bit closer to have a look. And I'm just going to pull him out, stop him so we can talk without that going. Now, Otto is set up with his pins. These are his left leg, right leg, as I told you, foot, left, right, and the buses on 13. And where you find that, first of all, structure is up here. This is the setup loop, or and loop. So it's the setup and loop. So you set it up. Otto's first beginners, you only need this one, which is the pins for the legs, the servos. But we've actually added a matrix mouth, and where you find that, LEDs, you click that, and then LED mouth. And there you go. So you got, just click it, hold on with the left button, drag out, and then it highlights and just drop, let go, and it goes in. And that's how it is. That's all you do, drag and drop. I'm going to get rid of that because I only need one of those blocks. Now here we have a repeat block, which is in the logic control. So the color matches the color on the menu. So this is a repeat. There's other ones, but at this stage, we're just going to use repeat. All right, and again, you could actually pop that in like that, and it pops in. Now, if you want to add a block, for instance, Otto's dancing, we might just do a sound, and that's from the buzzer. Okay, you can just drag and drop, right. You can use your middle wheel to scroll in and out as well, like that. So next part we are going to look at is, whoops. If you get that happening, you'll have to go down to the scroll bar and do that. Drag it on the loop, the biggest mouth part, which is the loop. Now I can change this. This is the matrix. So you can make it whatever you want. I'll make it into a mouth. You have got examples here. You're going to make a happy mouth, and that actually makes the sound, I think. You have mouth brightness. 10. Oh, okay. Is that a... I'm not sure what that is, actually. Anyway, we'll leave that for the time being. Won't worry about that. In the mouth, you have got the different ones you can do. Or we can have a happy smile, maybe. Let's have a try with that. So here we go in this. So we have sound happy and mouth happy. Okay, so we can try that. I'll put this back into the heart. Let's see how that goes. Okay, I think it's that way. Forgive me, but I think it's about what it is anyway. So we're going to come out, just scroll out. Oh, next part will be the dance functions or actions. Okay, so here we have dance, and in this case, you just click this arrow and you can change these to another type of dance, like crossing, whatever. The speed has normal, slow, very slow, fast, very fast, and way too fast. With our experience, we found that very fast and way too fast caused Otto to fall over. So I've asked my students just to use normal, slow, very slow, or fast. Leave it at that. Maybe with those very fast actions. You probably could use those for racing or something. Now the size of the step can change as well here. Got normal, little, big. So we could try big. So he's going to walk sideways left and then sideways right. Okay, so do big. Now there's a repeat. Because I want to speed this up, I'll just put this, highlight it, and just do two, okay? And I hit enter to do that. Leave these. Jitter do. You have some more you can do here. So the swing, jitter. So we've got jitter here already. Again, you can decide how fast or slow you want it. And we'll just leave it to normal. That's home, just brings Otto back to normal. Okay. Right. So I'm just going to go and hit the equal. That brings Otto's program back to there. Now, on the first time I check, I get the students to check the code in case they leave anything out or something goes wrong. We can always find it from the very beginning, though. It's the code. Now, to download that code, I'll show you. We have Otto. We're going to plug it in again. And I'll turn it up the right way. It's not going to go far on the cable. So plug it in. It double beeps and that says it's connected. Now when I say upload, double click beeps again and it's uploading that code and it says okay, uploaded. Fine, that's good. And now you should see that I am Otto. He goes forward, backward. Looks happy, smart. And it's swing. And that's it. So I am Otto forward after does the string. Smile. Heart. Moonwalk. Swing. And that's the jitter swing. Okay, and it's home. Now we can actually change this. So I get the students to put their own name in. Now it's all in upper case or capital, so get them press the cap lock. And I just got to click that again, click it there, highlight that bit, and I go Trish. The only problem with this is I know I've got too many letters in. The code, it is limited. I'll have to show you in full mode. It's limited to capital letters, but a maximum of 9 characters, okay? That's the coding, so it can't be changed as such. So click out of that, we'll go back to the blocks. And I know I have 10, so I am, so it includes spaces. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. To solve that problem is, I'll just get rid of that, click this, plus it, is I'm going to take, watch that, you have to highlight that, click it again, backspace, take out I am to I am, then duplicate the mouth. Okay, now I can put Trish. For students who have got long names, all they got to do is right click it again, duplicate it, add half a name in one block and then put it in the other, and no spaces. Okay, so we'll just check that. I did just check that. You can actually now upload it once you're more confident, the double beep. And it starts again. I am Trish. There you go. So this is a good introduction to Blocky, Otto Blocky. And certainly I found the students' confidence improved to the point where they started to look at all these different functions, okay? Now, since we're happy with the code now, we are going to save. So the students save it, and I often get them just to put their name in the first one. So just click it in there and just put dash. There we go. Let's save. So they save their code, and you can number it, their code, as a 1, 2, 3, like versions, as you go along with your lessons. Now, does Otto work without the cable? Yes. So this is Otto. Okay. And I have a switch at the back just to prove that it does work without the cable. And we'll talk about that in the build. For watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more lessons and tutorials.